Yo, 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 what's up? It's your boy Chris Haywood with the Come Up Media. And today we got a very, very special vlog. And it's a special day because it's my birthday. Today we're going to chop up some good game. And of course, I'm going to share my experience when I went to Mexico and give y'all a little update on my life. So y'all check it out.
Hey, man, at this point, I'm just doing this shit for me. You know, they go hate anyway. Shit, they said I couldn't even make it this far. I'm waking up every day, nigga. I don't give a fuck. I'm going hard, nigga. You never know what's gonna happen. But I ain't going out like no bitch. Straight up. Today
I went swimming in. About to shower. Got a little dinner party to check out. So happy to be here. And it's about to begin. So let's get to it. We shout out to Mexico for a very, very special reason. The homie Ed and his lovely, lovely bride, Allison, got married in Playa. So we flew out there. And it was a long time coming because Cancun had canceled the trip about a year ago. So we finally got around to getting it done. So it was great. And it came at perfect timing in my life because, hey, man, your boy been working hard and your boy been grinding. And so this trip actually coincided with me hitting my annual income goal in May. So we've been doing the damn thing. So we was living it up, to say the least.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So stayed at a beautiful hotel right just outside of the beach. And, you know, the whole time I kept thinking, like, I was honestly just real proud of myself. You know what I mean? A year ago, you know, I was doing kind of bad. And
I know where I was at last year, man. This shit crazy, bro. This is what life about, man. Fuck that work shit. This is what life about. It's about experiences. Use your money to purchase experiences. That's why you need bread. So you cannot care.
And around the way, you know what I'm saying, in the hood, we talk about, if you talk about hit a lick, you know what I'm saying? If you're gonna hit a lick on somebody, it could be like robbing somebody, but that's not what we're talking about. If you hit a lick, it's mean like coming up on something. You come up on an opportunity to do something. So hitting a lick, you know what I mean, could be getting overtime, where they give an unlimited overtime, or it could be you find a box of iPhones and you about to sell them and make a profit. I hit a lick, I hit that PPP, and I was like, you know what? I'm about to lick this thing. So what I did, I lived on that PPP and I studied and I got my real estate license and I turned that PPP into 100 grand. It's like my favorite story in the Bible is the parable of talents. And I don't claim to be no Bible whiz, but how I seen that thing is when that master went off and he left his servants different amounts of talents or money, and to those who he gave 5 talents and he went and doubled it. And the one he gave 3 talents and he went and doubled it. And the one who had 1 talent, he went and buried it in the ground. So he was pleased with the servant who doubled the 5 to 10 and the 3 to 6. But the person who buried it in the ground and brought back the same, he was like, you lazy fool. Give you something and you didn't do nothing with it. And I don't believe in an anthropomorphic God, but I believe in a God of abundance. And it says in that scripture that those who have will have more, and those who have not will have everything taken away. I'm paraphrasing. When God give you a lick, God give you an opportunity, you better capitalize on that thing. When you do, you're gonna win and win and win. Because, I mean, have you ever heard that shit? Winners win. That's just true. You know what I mean? I was reading this book, man, and it really, at the trip, I was had this indescribable feeling and I really couldn't put it into words, and I wound up grabbing this book that I recommend for everybody, 100 Essays That Will Change the Way You Think. And it talked about the 3 types of happiness. Eric Gritton says that there are 3 primary forms of happiness: the happiness of pleasure, the happiness of grace, and the happiness of excellence. The happiness of pleasure is largely sensory. It's a good meal when you're hungry, the smell of air after it rains, probably having sex, you know what I'm saying, after you, all right, okay. The happiness of grace is gratitude. It's looking over and seeing the love of your life sleeping. I love this when my baby girl sleep next to me, you know what I mean? It's like appreciation, you know what I mean? Nothing has to happen in order for you to feel happiness of grace. It's walking outside like, man, I'm happy to be alive, right? There's the happiness of excellence, the kind of happiness that comes from the pursuit of something great. Not the moment you arrive at the top of the mountain and raise your fists in victory, but the process in falling in love with the hike. It is meaningful work. It is flow. It is the purpose that sears identity and builds character and channels our energy towards something greater. The feeling of, yo, I'm becoming what I said I was gonna become. It's like that feeling after a long workout, after you graduate from college and you went through a whole bunch of shit and you finally got there. Or maybe you didn't, you just made a stepping stone. That's what I was feeling. And one of the best feelings in the world is doing what you said you was gonna do. Because at the moment when you said you was gonna do that, you knew it was gonna be hard. You knew it was gonna be arduous. You knew it was gonna be tedious. You knew it was gonna be cumbersome. But you still put your mind to it. And y'all, man, like I said, I've been killing the game. I've been killing it. All glory to God. And so I was feeling that happiness of excellence in Mexico. It was just a beautiful moment for me that I won't forget. And I'm so appreciative that I feel like I can handle any situation that comes up in life. I feel like I'll be able to weather the storm. You can drop me anywhere and I'll be successful. But the lessons that I got, the appreciation of knowing how to hit that lick, man, hit that opportunity and turn it into something, turn that 4 into 8. Feeling the happiness of excellence, you know? The happiness of excellence, meaning I am who I say I am. I'm becoming who I say I am. After being battle tested, after being resilient, that's a great feeling, man. It's a great feeling. So anyway, man, y'all know what it is. I tried to keep this video kind of short. I got another part 2 coming, but I got to get this video out for my birthday. So anyway, man, y'all know what it is. God bless. Y'all know this, create or die. Peace.